A two-column proof is shown below. Enter the reason for step 5. A two-column proof is like a mathematical story. And you start with a given, that's some information you start with, and then you reason through and you reach a conclusion, which is a proof statement. Now the given statement is always first. Angle 2 and angle 3 are both complementary to angle 1. Notice that's the first statement right here. The proof statement, measure of angle 2 equals measure of angle 3, that always is the last statement. That's what you're concluding. And then in the middle is a series of steps that allow you to logically reason through the process and reach an appropriate conclusion. Now to put the reason for a given statement, you just write the word given right here. And then these steps in the middle, they're logical conclusions based on the given. So let's reason through it. Angle 2 and angle 3 are both complementary to angle 1, that is given. Measure of angle 2 plus measure of angle 1 is 90 degrees. Well, that's true because angle 2 is complementary to angle 1, which means the measures add to 90 degrees, and that's based on the definition of complementary angles, which says two angles are complementary if and only if their sum is 90 degrees. The same can be said for step 3, measure of angle 3, measure of angle 1, those add to make 90 degrees. So measure of angle 3 plus measure of angle 1 equals 90 degrees, based on the definition of complementary angles, because 3 is complementary to angle 1 also. And let's look at this next statement. We have measure of angle 2 plus measure of angle 1 equals measure of angle 3 plus measure of angle 1. Right here, and right here. That's where these pieces of information come from. From step 2, measure of angle 2 plus measure of angle 1 equals 90 degrees. Step 3, measure of angle 3 plus measure of angle 1 equals 90 degrees. That's where these pieces of information from step 4 come from. And then they both equal 90 degrees, which means they have to be equal to each other. So you can substitute one of these measures for the 90 degrees. So if you take this first statement, measure of angle 2 plus measure of angle 1 equals 90 degrees, and substitute in here the measure of angle 3 plus measure of angle 1, you get the step 4 based on the substitution property of equality. And look at statement 4 to 5. What's the difference between 4 and 5? Well, this measure of angle 1 is gone. It just says measure of angle 2 equals measure of angle 3. And since the measure of angle 1 is originally added to both sides on step 4, the reason that you can say measure of angle 2 equals measure of angle 3 is a subtraction property of equality. Okay, so this is what you would enter for the answer for step 5 here. And also, I wanted to make sure I went through introducing a two-column proof and explaining the reasoning behind putting the steps together.